Welcome students to the 9th lecture of biology. It is a continuation of respiration in plants. You already understand what respiration is and what are the various phenomena undergoing in respiration. But today we'll start with which parts of the plant respire. It has been proved that every part of the plant respire, even the deeply placed roots, they respire through the general surface. Talking about leaves, they respire through special structures called stomata. The stems, they respire through special pores called lenticels. The whole plant respires throughout the life of the plant. But what about photosynthesis? Photosynthesis is performed only by green plants, and that too in the presence of light. Let's see how respiration and photosynthesis are antagonistic and complementary to each other. Actually, respiration and photosynthesis both are involved in gaseous exchange. The substrate of one process is the end product of the other process. Let's see how. Photosynthesis utilizes carbon dioxide, water, and in the presence of sunlight performs photosynthesis, produces glucose and oxygen. On the other hand, the plant, when it is respiring, it oxidizes glucose in the presence of oxygen to release carbon dioxide and water and biochemical energy called adenosine triphosphate, that is ATP. Now, to check how the plant is performing photosynthesis, which is a light dependent process, we see that photosynthesis starts in the plant during sunrise, and as the day progresses, the intensity of sunlight increases and the rate of photosynthesis also increases, releasing lot of oxygen. At noon time, as gradually the day progresses, we see that the rate of photosynthesis and the rate of respiration become equivalent to each other. This shows that the oxygen which is provided is utilized by the plant for the process of respiration, releasing carbon dioxide. That means there is no release of oxygen or carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. This time of the noon time is called compensation point. Now, as the day progresses, more intensity of sunlight increases, and by afternoon the rate of photosynthesis is so much that it even exceeds and leaves behind the rate of respiration. In the evening, the light intensity has decreased, so the photosynthesis rate again decreases down, and we see that now once again a time has come that the rate of respiration and rate of photosynthesis also become equivalent. Again, the plant reaches to compensation point. This shows that the plant reaches compensation point twice in a day. Now let's see what happens at night. At night, no sunlight, no photosynthesis, and no release of oxygen. So the plant is respiring and releasing the whole of the carbon dioxide out into the atmosphere. This proves that why elders keep on saying that don't sleep under the trees during the night time. Now, photosynthesis and respiration, this is how they are complementary and antagonistic to each other. Now, in respiration, to prove that how they are of two types, aerobic and anaerobic respiration, we will be discussing few experiments. But before that, students, these are the very important instructions you have to take care. Please read the aim of the experiment very carefully and observe the apparatus and the parts of it also very carefully. Be alert to check the material which is used in the apparatus and the significance of the material. And when we are discussing, be alert to understand the observations as well as the inference of the experiment. To begin with, we start with the first experiment, which is demonstration of aerobic respiration through germinating seeds. For this, we have taken a special apparatus which is called respiroscope, which is actually a round bulb which is to which an inverted tube is attached, which is open on this end. We have taken two respiroscopes, A and B. In A, we have used germinating seeds, and B, we have used dry seeds. The two bent tubes, in them we have placed potassium hydroxide, and we have tried to dip them in a beaker containing mercury. The whole setup is placed for a few hours, and after a few hours, what we observe is that the germinating seeds, they keep on germinating and respiring, utilizing the oxygen in the apparatus and releasing carbon dioxide side by side, which leads to a vacuum in this area, due to which the mercury in the beaker moves and rises in the tube. In B setup, there was no respiration, so no change in the whole setup, and even the mercury did not rise up. So through this apparatus, we have tried to explain that during aerobic respiration, oxygen is utilized and carbon dioxide is released, which is absorbed by potassium hydroxide. Now in the second experiment, we are trying to discuss alcoholic fermentation, which is a phase of anaerobic respiration in plants. For this also, we have taken a special vessel called Kuhne's vessel. Students, be very alert in learning the names of these vessels. Now, this Kuhne's vessel is also a bulb-like structure to which an inverted tube is attached, but this tube is sealed from this end, and a stopper is placed at the opening of the bulb. In this apparatus, we are placing a special mixture prepared, which is 5% glucose along with yeast. Keeping this whole setup for a few hours, what we observe is there is a frothy appearance in this area, and the level of the mixture, which was at the tip in the beginning of the experiment, which was very important to see, has come down, making a gap over here. Now, frothy appearance and a gap indicates that some gas has been released over here, released in the setup and come over here. What to check that, what we do is, we use again, remove the stopper and place potassium hydroxide and immediately close the lid. Now, when we open it, we can smell the alcohol. The potassium hydroxide, which was placed over here, has absorbed the gas, and again, once again, the mixture in this side tube rises up. Now, no gap is over there after potassium hydroxide has absorbed this gas. Because potassium hydroxide is able to absorb carbon dioxide, so it indicates that carbon dioxide was released. The smell indicates that alcohol has been formed. So this proves our experiment that yeast, being a plant, has performed alcoholic fermentation and released carbon dioxide. For your understanding, we have written the observations and inference in this slide. Now to continue, we come to the third experiment, in which we are trying to prove two things. Oxygen is used up during respiration and carbon dioxide is released. In this setup we have placed, though it seems to be a complicated one, but if we start with this to understand, we have taken in C, we have taken a glass sheet above which we have placed a potted plant, and a bell jar has been inverted. While bell jar is being inverted, care has taken that the rim of the bell jar is sealed with the Vaseline so that the whole apparatus becomes airtight. The upper end of the bell jar is having a stopper with two holes, to which there are two bent tubes attached to it. To the left side, this bent tube is going to come into a bottle containing lime water. And on this end, another bent tube comes out and joins with a U-tube containing soda lime. And to the extreme end of the apparatus, there is another bent tube coming out. Now, on the right side of the setup C, this bent tube comes and enters the bottle D, which is again containing lime water. And in this bottle D, there is a stopper to which the second bent tube is attached, which is attached to the aspirator. In the beginning, we place a stopper to the aspirator. We also take care that a black cloth is covering the bell jar so that no photosynthesis is performed by the plant, only respiration takes place. Now, to what we have used over here is lime water in these two bottles and soda lime. Students, be very careful to understand what is the nature of these liquids. It is, they absorb carbon dioxide. To begin the experiment, we remove the stopper over here and the air flow moves from setup A to B to C to D. Now, in setup A, the air which is entering is loaded with oxygen, carbon dioxide and nitrogen, and carbon dioxide is absorbed by soda lime, and the air which moves from A to B to C, now it is free from carbon dioxide, only oxygen and nitrogen is there, which is proved by the lime water which remains clear, does not turn milky. Now the air now which is entered over here, it is used by the plant for respiration, which is loaded with oxygen, and when plant is respiring, it releases carbon dioxide. Now this carbon dioxide moves to the bent tube towards the D bottle and turns the lime water milky. This turning of lime water milky indicates that the plant had released only and only carbon dioxide after respiration. So this experiment setup proves our aim that the plant has utilized oxygen for respiration and released carbon dioxide. Here we have placed the observation and the inference for your understanding. This is the end of the topic respiration in plants. And students, this was the last lecture before we go for the summer holidays. Enjoy your holidays and have a nice time. There would be a worksheet following, which you please try to complete it. Thank you.